Prime Minister Narendra Modi speak on the last day of the Lok Sabha session of this tenure. Remember, after this, of course, the House will be adjourned sine die, but this is the last term that this session will take place, of course. Remember, after this, there will be Lok Sabha elections, which perhaps will happen anytime between April and May, although, of course, the exact dates we'll only know once the Election Commission notifies them. Sumit Peer, political analyst, is live with us. Sumit, let me quickly bring you in for your take on the Prime Minister's address just a short while back, the PM speaking on the last day of Parliament, the Lok Sabha Speaker also right now, of course, recapping what all has happened in the last 5 years.
Uday, thanks for having me on your show. What we saw is a 360-degree speech. It was a political speech. It was highlighting what the government did, what the Parliament together did. And he thanked all the MPs. He thanked all the MPs across the party lines. He was very categorical in talking about 370 women's reservation bill, efficiency of 97%, new Parliament building. And there was a very nice and a very subtle mention of Ram Mandir, which is a national reality now. And the whole nation has accepted the fact because it happened after the court's verdict and all. So the overall, it was basically counting what the Parliament together did, what, how many, you know, like 370 and all, there are a lot of people who supported. And even today, he was kind of saying that they'll be good if some, all the people would be here rather than some people walking out. Idea here was, what did this Parliament and what did this group of MPs achieve as a group? It was not a BJP achievement, it was not an NDA achievement, that everybody knows, but he thanked everybody and said a lot of new benchmarks have been made, a lot of new milestones have been set, and for the next Parliament, for the next people who come into the Parliament, the standards are set, they have to aspire to do better than this. So pushing the scale up is what Honorable Prime Minister basically said. Say, I put the scale at a different level. It has not got, you know, 10 years back, the scale was at a different level. Today, it is at a different level. And now, the people who have to come, at least they have to match the level or at least do better. So that is how the speech was. I don't see it as any political speech. It was a very cordial speech, and he addressed the parliamentarians and the nation as such. Uday.
Right. Sumit, as far as, of course, the recapping, of course, of what all the government has done comes also on a day when the, Parliament has also spoken about the historic Ram Mandir, Pran Pratishtha that we saw just a few days ago. In fact, last month on the 22nd, it comes on a day when the Parliament has also, spoken about this very important point in India's history. And we heard the Home Minister speak on it as well.
You see, Ram Mandir is the reality. Uday, Ram Mandir was something which was done by an invader, a terrorist called Babar. And by the due course of law, after waiting for 550 years and 135 years in court, the Hindu community has got it right as per the rule of the law. There is no political power used, no muscle power used, it's not bulldozing your way through. The rule of the land has prevailed in this case. Some people like Oweisi ji are very unhappy. I have seen him talking about Babri Masjid thi hai aur rahegi, Babri Masjid Zindabad and all. This is all, this is all political gimmick, mimicry or gaming what he's trying to do. But the reality remains, whatever was done by a foreign invader has been set only on in India after 550 years. And by due course of law, this is where the Modi government gets the credit. And let me tell you, Uday sir, not even one drop of blood was spilled anywhere. Name a country, imagine a civilization, imagine a culture where such a thing will happen. And you will, people, 140 crore people have accepted this reality. That's what Mr. Amit Shah had to say. It's the reality of life, we have to accept it. And it has went as per the rule of the law. It doesn't matter what do you think, believe, assume or presume. That doesn't matter. Mr. Oweisi might have his own apprehensions, might have his own thought process, or he might be emotional, or he might be wanting to make his political capital out of it. He is entitled to that. But the reality remains, Babri Masjid was first built when the Bhagwan Shri Ram temple was demolished by Babar. And then in the due course of law, the Ram Mandir came up, and it's a Bhavya Ram Mandir. It's a part of our culture and it's a part of our Sabhita. And people like Oweisi ji and all forget when it was the time of Bhagwan Shri Ram, everybody was a Hindu. All the Muslims of India, 99.99% are converted Hindus. So you can't say that, nobody got a hitch with a lift on a horseback from Babar while coming from Uzbekistan. Babar came from Uzbekistan.
Right. Let me also bring in Utpal Kaul, historian, into the discussion. Utpal Kaul, Prime Minister, of course, speaking on the last day of Lok Sabha. We are hearing, of course, from the Lok Sabha Speaker as well, Om Birla, just looking back at the 5 years that have gone by of this particular tenure of Parliament, even as the Lok Sabha will adjourn today, sine die, and this session will come to an end. This tenure of the Lok Sabha will come to an end ahead of the elections later this year.
Uday, basically, it was a Prime Minister Modi ji was recapitulating what last 5 years Parliament has done. Basically, he said the Parliament has done, but the BJP, what the BJP government did. And as Sumit ji has said that Modi ji counted from each one point what he did, and he highlighted like Article 370 and empowerment of women, social justice for women, and then he added that the space, not directly saying about the moon, but space and navy, and then he said about the parliament building. He also mentioned that this parliament, high-tech parliament building, will be a foundation for future parliamentarians to have a good and most important is that he highlighted it was a speech for future. That means now what he achieved all these 5 years, and that he reminded at the end of this session, and this was the very difficult situation which the our chairman of the parliament said that it was because of the COVID was also there, but Prime Minister took care of people of India, and he took even care of the parliamentarians. So it was now about the Padma Awards, that Padma Awards was given to the genuine people. So these were the points which he highlighted, what he basically did for all these 5 years. And he mentioned about the G20, that how the India got the prestige all over the world. They organized it very well. So, and the Ram Mandir is most important thing. So, one by one, Modi ji highlighted all the points, all the achievements which for last 5 years Modi government and BJP had, did it. But he never mentioned the BJP or his government. He said the parliament has done all these great achievements.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.